But you have a love for children, and especially over the last many years, you've done children's songs, you've done in the group, you've done incredible children's stuff. Tell me why you continue to do so much of your focus, especially to the present day, on entertaining and doing meaningful things.
I think, and I've recently started mentoring teenagers, which I never thought I would do, because I've had teenagers. Why would you go in there? But there's something very fulfilling about it, connecting with little ones and all the way through teens. You know, you asked me earlier about the different musical styles, and it's really the same answer. I go where the juice is. I want to go to what excites me and where my heart is. And that always takes me somewhere interesting. And that's why my music has changed and evolved, because, like I said, I was schizophrenic musically. So I'd start with a country thing with Messina, and next thing I know, I'm making an R&B record. I did Footloose, and Columbia goes, oh, great, we finally figured out who he is, and the next thing I do is make an R&B record. So I've been a moving target all these years. But with and then I finally had a leap of faith, which was the only record in my career where I had five singles from that record. And then I called Don Einer at Columbia Records and said, I want to make a children's record. And he said, take it down the street, because we don't want it. And so I did, and I ended up at a label called Sony Wonder. And 2 million units later, he was so pissed at me that he dropped me on the label. You know, so what are you going to do? But that's where I just had this idea of writing a new verse to House to Corner, and because I've been singing songs for my children at night for all those years, and I had a whole repertoire of night songs. Mm-hmm. Like on the first album, Return to Blue Corner, the first children's album that I did. I did a cover of John Lennon's Love. Love is real, because I've been singing that to my daughter.